What's up everybody, welcome to a new video. Today I'm gonna show you a very quick tip for Instagram which allows you to post different aspect ratio in the same post. It's something that I thought was not possible to do, but it's been bugging me for a little while now. A friend of mine is posting regularly like new posts, and I'm gonna show you like what it looks like. But when you scroll through the pictures, the aspect ratio is different and like the whole layout actually adapts to it, which is pretty nice. I wanted to do the same thing. I couldn't find anything online on how to do it. So I just asked him and he gave me the solution. He actually didn't even know he was doing that. I'll tell you more about it. But first, let's go through his account. So to show you an example, he's actually a very good photographer. You should follow him for like nice pictures from the Alps. And let's look at a post, like the latest one, for example, it's landscape mode. And you can see second picture landscape mode. And then it's a square. And the text below and like the like and everything just like kind of shift as you scroll. It's a bit of an interesting behavior, like not a lot of accounts post this kind of stuff or use this feature because it's kind of a hidden feature. And this one, you can see it does the same thing. So this really allows you full control over the aspect ratio of your pictures. This one is all landscape. You can see this one as well is like all landscape, but like this one is not as tall as this one. And controlling the aspect ratio in photography, I think, is pretty important. Like it allows you to refocus on your subject and include really just what you want and not too much detail, but like not lose details by cropping either. So I think it's really important and it's a really cool feature to be able on Instagram to add custom aspect ratio like this. So anyways, I wanted to be able to do that as well. And he told me like the tool he's using for this to work. I'm gonna do it on the desktop because that's where it's happening. It's Facebook Creator Studio. Facebook Creator Studio for Instagram. He told me he's actually using it in the first place just to post both on Facebook and Instagram at the same time, which is a cool feature. I don't even want to use that feature. If you can use it just for Instagram, it's fine. So you click here. When you're not logged in on it for the first time, you know, you need to connect it to a Facebook page. So I didn't have a Facebook page, but I created one, like a Funkyval Facebook page that I put actually as unpublished. You don't need to have it public and like stuff like this. Just the page needs to exist and you connect it to your Instagram account. So it's like not much of a big deal. Like I'm not gonna show you that because when you log in here for the first time, they explain you everything how to do it. And once you manage to log in with your page and stuff, you can actually go in create post here, Instagram feed, and then you go there. I have two accounts. I have Funkyval, my main account, and I have Le Software for like buckets, ice buckets, really cool account. But anyways, follow them if you're interested into this kind of content. And here you write your post, like whatever description, you know, you can add a location, like same feature as on Instagram, I mean Montreal. So you can add that here and then add content. You can add your photos here. So I'm gonna do from file upload. You can also import photos from a Facebook page post that you did, but I'm not interested into that here. And here I'm gonna show you those pictures that are actually like, one is a square because I think it makes most sense for this one to be in a square. It was usually like, normally it was landscape, but I think the square just includes all the details I want and the rest was kind of useless. So I think this is better. But this one I really wanted as a portrait. I didn't want to cut it as a square just because I really want the details. Like if I put it as a square, like mostly the helmet is gonna be cropped or then like I miss a bunch of the motorcycle. So this one I want to keep like this as well. And to be able to do that, so you import them here in the Creator Studio. And you can see by default, it's a square for both. And you can tweak the crop here. So for example, I go here, it's already a square, so I'm not gonna do anything. But the second one, by default, is cropped as a square. You can actually like reframe it like this if you want to. But what I can do here is actually put it as vertical. And you can see that vertical is actually not the full height of my picture. Like it's still cropping a little bit. This is like the maximum vertical size that Instagram allows you. But it's still like much better than a square, you know. So I'm gonna go back to vertical. I'm saving here. And you can see the first one still is a square. And this one still is vertical. And it looks from the UI, it looks that they add black borders to it, but it's not actually true. Like there's no black borders in the final picture. It's gonna do the effect that I showed you just before, where like the content shifts around it. It's like the proper aspect ratio. I'm not gonna publish it here because I already posted that yesterday, but I'm gonna go on my profile. I'm gonna show exactly what this would have done. So it's still recording. Yeah, that's good. And that's the square. Where is that? Oh yeah. my remote camera connection was lost, we don't really care about that, it's still filming. And then I go there and you can, oh come on, yeah that's me. And then you can see the full portrait mode here, and this one as well, so really it shifts the content around when you scroll, so that's exactly the effect I wanted, I'm very happy about that. And that's it for today, I hope this tip was useful to you. Have a great day, I'll see you in the next video.